Ito po ang huling Biyernes ng buwan ng Mayo at kahapon, May 26, 2022 ay nagpulong ang inyong Interagency Task Force or IATF para aprubahan ang rekomendasyong Sub-Technical Working Group for Data Analytics tungkol po sa Alert Level Classification mula June 1, 2022 hanggang June 15. Umpisahan po natin sa Alert Level 1. Naka-flash sa inyong mga screen ang mga lugar na nasa Alert Level 1. Basahin po natin isa-isa. Buong National Capital Region. Sa Cordillera Autonomous Region naman po, kasama ang Abra, Apayao, Kalinga, Mountain Province, Baguio City. Sa Region 1, Ilocos Norte, Ilocos Sur, La Union, Pangasinan at Dagupan City. Sa Region 2, Batanes, Cagayan, Isabela, Nueva Vizcaya, Quirino at ang City of Santiago. Sa Region 3 naman, Aurora, sakop din po ang Bataan, Bulacan, Nueva Ecija, Pampanga, Tarlac, Zambales, Angeles City at Olongapo City. Sakop naman po sa ilalim ng Region 4A ang Batangas, Cavite, Laguna, Rizal at Lucena City. Sa Region 4B, Marinduque, Oriental Mindoro, Romblon at ang Puerto Princesa City. Sa Region 5 po, sakop po ang Albay, Catanduanes at Naga City sa ilalim po ng Alert Level 1. Sa Region 6, Aklan, Capiz, Guimaras, Iloilo, Bacolod City at Iloilo City. Sa Region 7 po, sakop po ng Alert Level 1 ang Siquijor, Cebu City, Lapu-Lapu City at ang Mandaue City. Sa Region 8, sakop po ang probinsya ng Biliran, Eastern Samar, Southern Leyte, Ormoc City at Tacloban City. Sa Region 9, sakop po ang Zamboanga City. Sa Region 10, Bukidnon, Camiguin, Misamis Occidental, Misamis Oriental, Cagayan de Oro City at Iligan City. Sa Region 11, Davao City po at Davao Oriental. Sa Caraga naman po, sakop po ang Surigao del Sur at ang Butuan City. Samantala, inaprubahan na din ng IATF base po sa rekomendasyon ng Commission on Higher Education ang pag-repeal sa medical insurance ng mga estudyante na nakasaad sa CHED-DOH Joint Memorandum Circular number 2021-004. In addition, the IATF, upon the recommendations of the Technical Working Group, approved in yesterday's meeting the following entry, testing and quarantine protocols for Filipinos and foreign nationals arriving from abroad, beginning this Monday, May the 30th. Let us go and discuss foreign nationals entering the Philippines. Foreign nationals may enter the Philippines provided that they comply with the applicable visa requirements and immigration entry and departure formalities, and provided further that they are fully vaccinated against COVID-19. Except only for minor children below 12 years of age traveling with their fully vaccinated foreign parents. Foreign nationals must likewise carry or possess any of the following acceptable proof of COVID-19 vaccination, which shall be presented prior to departing or boarding from the country of origin or the port of embarkation and upon arrival in the country. 1. The World Health Organization International Certificate of Vaccination and Prophylaxis. 2. VaxCert PH. 3. The National or State Manual or Digital Vaccination Certificate of the country or the foreign government. 4. Other proof of vaccination permitted by the IATF. In addition, foreign nationals must present a negative RT-PCR test taken within 48 hours or a remotely supervised or a laboratory-based rapid antigen negative test result administered and certified by a healthcare professional in a healthcare facility, laboratory, clinic, pharmacy, or other similar establishment taken within 24 hours prior to the date and time of departure from the country of origin or the first port of embarkation in a continuous travel to the Philippines, excluding layovers, and provided that he or she has not left the airport premises or has not been admitted into another country during such layover. The following, however, shall be exempted from this pre-departure testing requirement. 1. Foreign nationals aged 18 and above who have received primary series COVID-19 vaccine and at least one COVID-19 booster shot. 2. Foreign nationals aged 12 to 17 who are fully vaccinated. And 3. Foreign nationals aged below 12, regardless of their vaccination status, who are accompanied by their parents or guardians. Foreign nationals must also have passports valid for a period of at least 6 months at the time of their arrival to the Philippines. For temporary visitors, they must have valid tickets for their return journey to the port of origin or next port of destination corresponding to their permitted allowable duration of stay under a valid visa or visa-free entry, as the case may be. However, this shall not apply to foreign spouses and or children of Filipino citizens and former Filipino citizens with balikbayan privilege under Republic Act Number 9174, including their foreign spouse and or children who are not balikbayans in their own right and are traveling with them to the Philippines. Foreign nationals who fail to fully comply with the conditions and requisites set shall be denied admission into the country and shall be subject to the appropriate exclusion proceedings. Once admitted into the country, they are no longer required to observe facility-based quarantine but shall self-monitor for any sign or symptom for 7 days. Let us now go to foreign children traveling with Filipino nationals. A foreign child or children below 12 years of age who are not vaccinated for any reason whatsoever and traveling with their Filipino parent shall follow the entry, testing, and quarantine protocols of their Filipino parent traveling with them. A foreign child or children from ages 12 to 17 years of age traveling with their Filipino parent shall follow the protocol based on their vaccination status. For example, whether vaccinated or unvaccinated. In case of such unvaccinated minor children, either the foreign or Filipino parents should accompany such child or children during their facility-based quarantine. Para naman po sa mga Pilipinong fully vaccinated, maaari po silang pumasok ng Pilipinas. Basta sumunod lamang sila sa requirements. Ano-ano ang mga ito? Well, they shall carry or possess an acceptable proof of vaccination. They must present a negative RT-PCR test taken within 48 hours or a remotely supervised or laboratory-based rapid antigen negative test result administered and certified by a healthcare professional in a healthcare facility, laboratory, clinic, pharmacy, or other similar establishment taken within 24 hours naman prior to the date and time of departure from the country of origin or the first port of embarkation in a continuous travel to the Philippines, excluding layovers provided that he or she has not left the airport premises or has not been admitted into another country during such layover. The following, however, shall be exempted from this pre-departure testing requirement. Filipinos age 18 and above who have received primary series COVID-19 vaccine and at least one COVID-19 booster shot. Filipinos age 12 to 17 who are fully vaccinated. Filipinos age below 12, regardless of their vaccination status, who are accompanied by their parents or guardians. How about unvaccinated, partially unvaccinated, or individuals whose vaccination status cannot be independently validated? Can they enter the Philippines? The answer is still yes, as long as they can present a negative RT-PCR test taken within 48 hours or a remotely supervised or a negative laboratory-based rapid antigen negative test result administered and certified by a healthcare professional in a healthcare facility, laboratory, clinic, pharmacy, or other similar establishment taken within 24 hours prior to the date and time of departure from the country of origin or the first port of embarkation in a continuous travel to the Philippines, excluding layovers, provided that he or she has not left the airport or terminal premises or has not been admitted into another country during such layover. They are required to undergo facility-based quarantine until the release of their negative RT-PCR test taken on the fifth day from the date of arrival, after which they shall be required to undergo home quarantine until their 14th day from date of arrival. The local government units of their destination and their respective Barangay Health Emergency Response Teams, or BERTs, are tasked to monitor those arriving passengers undergoing home quarantine. Sa mga Pilipino po na menor de edad na hindi pa nababakunahan for any reason whatsoever, susundin nila ang quarantine protocols ng kanilang mga magulang or adult or guardian na kasama nila sa biyahe. Filipino nationals from 12 years to 17 years of age shall follow the classification and procedures based on their vaccination status, whether they're vaccinated or unvaccinated. In case of such unvaccinated minor children, either foreign or Filipino parents should accompany such child or children during their facility-based quarantine. Paano naman po ang mga Pilipinong fully recovered pero nag-positive pa rin sa kanilang pre-departure test? Ito po ang sagot. Maaari silang pumasok po ng Pilipinas. Kailangan lamang nilang magpresenta ng mga sumusunod na mga dokumento prior to departing or boarding from the country of origin or the port of embarkation and upon arrival in the Philippines. 1. A positive RT-PCR test taken not earlier than 10 days but not later than 30 days prior to the date and time of departure from the country of origin or the port of embarkation. 2. An RT-PCR test taken within 48 hours prior to the date and time of departure from the country of origin or the first port of embarkation in a continuous travel to the Philippines, again, excluding layovers, provided that he or she has not left the airport premises or has not been admitted into another country during such layover. And 3, a medical certificate issued by a licensed physician stating that the Filipino national certifying that he or she was an asymptomatic, mild, moderate, severe, or critical case of COVID-19, as the case may be, and has completed the mandatory isolation period, is no longer infectious, and has been allowed free movement and travel. Upon arrival, the COVID-19 positive Filipino national shall be subject to the following protocols. If fully vaccinated, they shall no longer be required to observe mandatory facility-based quarantine, but shall self-monitor for any sign or symptom for 7 days, with the first day being the date of arrival, and shall be required to report to the local government unit of destination upon the manifestation of symptoms, if there are any. If unvaccinated, partially vaccinated, or vaccination status cannot be independently determined, they shall be required to undergo facility-based quarantine until the release of their negative RT-PCR test taken on the fifth day, after which they shall be required to undergo home quarantine until their 14th day, with the date of arrival being the first day. The IATF likewise resolved that all inbound passengers, whether Filipinos or foreign nationals, shall register with the One Health Pass prior to arrival in the Philippines, unless exempted under relevant IATF resolutions. Sa usaping bakuna, as of May 26, 2022, nasa mahigit 73.7 million na ang naka-first dose, habang nasa mahigit 69 million ang fully vaccinated ayon sa National COVID-19 Vaccination Dashboard. Nasa halos 14 million naman ang naka-booster shots. Overall, nasa higit 150 million ang total doses administered. At sa mga chikiting na edad 5 hanggang 11 taong gulang, nasa 2.7 million na ang fully vaccinated. Samantala, ang mga batang 12 hanggang 17 anyos, nasa higit 9.3 million ang fully vaccinated as of May 26, 2022. Sa ating mga lolo at lola, mga senior citizens natin, nasa 6.7 million ang fully vaccinated seniors as of May 26, 2022. Pumunta na tayo po sa mga tanong ng MPC. Good afternoon po sa inyo, Yusek Rocky.
Good afternoon, Yusek Ablan. Ang una po nating, good afternoon po sa Malacanang Press Corps. Unang tanong mula po kay Rose Novenario ng Hataw. Ano daw po yung preparation sa inauguration on June 30, 2022 ng PCOO? Papayagan na ba uli na magkaroon daw po ng regular access sa Malacanang ang palace reporters, photogs, and cameramen kahit walang negative RT-PCR test result?
Alright, maraming salamat po, Yusek Rocky, at salamat sa tanong mo, Ma'am Rose. Dalawa po yung tanong na yan. Ang unang sagot po ay handang-handa na po ang Presidential Communications Operations Office para sa inauguration on 12 noon ng June 30. Inactivate na po ni Secretary Martin Andanar ang mga teams para sa inauguration. Kabilang na po dito ang RTVM o ang Radio Television Malacanang at ang Philippine Information Agency. So we are just coordinating with the Office of the President Appointments Office. Pangalawa naman po, kung doon po sa tanong kung papayagan na po ang ating mga media na pumasok kahit na wala pong negative RT-PCR test, we have to defend po sa PSG, no? Buhay po ng ating outgoing president at incoming president ang nakasalalay, so we will abide by the protocols of the Presidential Security Guards.
Opo.
Group.
Second question from Vic Sumintak ng DCEC Net 25, reaction daw po, palace reaction, President-elect BBM handang gawing anti-illegal drug czar si Pangulong Duterte. Similar question po yan ni Alvin Baltasar, ni Paul Samarita ng TV5 at saka ni Jinky Badikados ng IBC 13.
Alright, maraming salamat ulit sa mga tanong ni Sir Vic at nila Chris. Pagdating po dyan, no, there is no legal impediment for former president to assume an executive position in the executive branch. Actually, pwede nga rin tumakbo, no? Hindi lang po sa pagkapangulo muli. So wala pong legal impediment dyan. Now, whether tatanggapin po yan ni President Duterte, nasa kanya na po yan. Sa pag-alam po namin, the president is looking forward to his retirement. Pero welcome po yung balita na yan dahil si President na mismo ang nagsabi na kailangan pa rin tuloy-tuloy po ang laban sa droga.
Opo. Pero ang follow-up po yung sa Chris ni Chris Jose ng Remate Online, kung may balak ba daw si President Duterte na maging drug war czar sa ilalim ng Bongbong Marcos administration? Similar question po yan ni MJ Blancaflor.
Right. Salamat kay Chris saka kay MJ. Yusek Rocky, yung sagot po dyan is very similar sa sagot ko kanina, no? Na kay Presidente Duterte na po ang desisyon kung tatanggapin po niya o gugustuhin po ba niya maging drug czar sa ilalim po ng isang BBM administration.
Opo. Yusek Rick, ang susunod na magtatanong, si Pia Rañada ng Rappler via Zoom.
Hi, Pia.
Hello, good afternoon, Yusek Ablan. Sir, because it's already, the proclamation has happened already, so we just wanted to get updates on whether or not nakapag-decide na po yung transition team na Malacanang on when to meet with the Marcos camp.
Right, no. As you already know, Pia, that the President has already activated the transition team of the Office of the President. We are not privy, no, whether or not they've already activated it and actually met with the transition team of the incoming President. Insofar as PCO is concerned, Secretary Martin has activated the transition team. I am included in that. And we have sent feelers to incoming PCO Secretary Trixie Cruz Angeles. And we hope to meet with them soon so that there is a proper turnover between outgoing Secretary Andanar and incoming Secretary Cruz Angeles.
Okay, so to clarify, USEC, there has been no response from the incoming press secretary on transition.
No, we are. We've sent already our invitation to the incoming secretary. I'm not yet privy on whether or not they've responded to that. We will let the Malacañang Press Corps know when that transition meeting will happen. But we foresee it to be in the coming days. Secretary Andanar has instructed me to provide a proper and full turnover to the incoming secretary, not unlike what we experienced 6 years ago. And so we will provide them with all the information that they need and with all the assistance. I will be staying over, so I will be in charge of the transition.
You will be staying over, meaning you will be retaining your position in the PCO. Hindi po kayo co-terminus, tama po ba?
Yes, that is correct, Pia. I am a career official under the Career Executive Service Board with the rank of CESO 1. I am the first CESO of PCOO in its history, and I am very optimistic and excited to welcome the incoming secretary and her incoming officials and designates.
Mm-hmm. And then, sir, just to clarify the announcements earlier dun sa IATF resolution, no, dun sa travel rules, yung arrival, is this basically the first time we are lifting the requirement for pre-departure test for foreigners and Filipinos? Tama po ba yung understanding ko?
I'm not sure, Pia, if it's the first time, but the difference between this IATF resolution is we did lift the requirements on medical insurance, and it makes it easier for our travelers to come to our shores.
Okay. And then lastly from me, USEC, because we've been talking about the economic trajectory of the incoming administration, and palaging pinag-uusapan, sir, yung almost 13 trillion debt that the Duterte administration will be leaving the Marcos administration to deal with. So just for the benefit of Filipinos, can you just explain for everyone why there was a 13 trillion debt, and is there anything else that the current administration is doing to widen the fiscal space for the incoming administration?
All right. I can't answer the reason why there is a debt, Pia, but I can assure you with the announcement of the camp of incoming President Bongbong Marcos of his economic team that the country is in good hands with the incoming secretaries of the Department of Finance, our Banco Central, as well as our DBM and our NEDA. So they're in good hands, Pia.
All right. Thank you, USEC.
No worries.
Okay, thank you, Pia. So, Yusa Chris, susunod na magtatanong si MJ Blanca Flor ng Daily Tribune, kung meron daw po nakaschedule na meeting si Pangulong Duterte with President-elect Marcos before June 30.
Alright, salamat sa tanong mo, MJ. Intayin na lang po natin ang announcement ng kasamahan ko sa PCOO Maro, sila Yusek Mia at saka sila Asek June Loyola. Sa announcement niya kung kailan po yung pulong nila.
From Alvin Baltasar ng Radyo Pilipinas, will the President attend Vice President Sara's inauguration rites on June 19? Similar question with Lanes Capanti ng GMA News Online.
All right, again for that question, Yusek Rocky, we have to wait, no, for the announcement coming from my colleagues, sila Yusek Mia Reyes, saka sila Asek June Loyola ng Maro, kung makaka-attend po ba si PRRD sa inauguration ng incoming Vice President.
Opo. Sunod na magtatanong si Paul Samarita ng TV5, anong plano ng Philippine government sa mga kababayan natin nais na umuwi na sa Sri Lanka? May nakausap kami na isang OFW at sabi niya marami ng mga kababayan na nagnanais na daw po makauwi. Ang presyo ng isang litro ng gasoline sa kanila ay nasa higit 2,000 per liter, habang ang isang kilo ay maglalaro sa 1,200 per kilo, pesos per kilo.
All right, maraming salamat, Paul. No, we can assure you that the Philippine government through the DFA is on top of the situation. We empathize po for our Filipino kababayan sa nasa Sri Lanka. Pero ayon po sa DFA, wala pa rin po silang natatanggap na tawag, no, mula sa ating mga Pilipino doon sa embahada natin sa Dhaka at sa honorary consulate natin sa Colombo. Pero pag nagkaroon po ng problema, tawagin lang po nila ang embahada o ang ating consulate para ma-repatriate na po sila. Pero sa ngayon po, wala pa po pong tumatawag sa kanila, but our embassy and consulate are on top of things in Sri Lanka.
Opo. Susunod na tanong mula kay Jinky Badikado sa IBC 13, pero ito yung sa quiz ay nasagot mo na, nakasama ito sa presentation mo about dun sa pre-departure test dun sa mga fully vaxxed tourists. From a current lema ng Reuters, does President Duterte plan to sign the Extended Producer Responsibility Act into law before his term ends? Environmental groups have criticized daw po the decision not to include bans on certain single-use plastic in the law. Could you respond? Unilever daw po and other consumer goods companies lobbied to have bans on single-use plastic removed from the law. Did this impact your government's decision?
Maraming salamat sa tanong mo, Karen. According po sa Malacañang Records Office or MRO, wala pa po silang natatanggap na bill on the Extended Producer Responsibility Act. So hindi pa po yan ma-actionan ng Office of the President. So intayin na lang po natin kung natanggap na po yan ng OP, and we follow the constitutional rules wherein the President can either lapse it into law or sign it into law or veto it. Pero wala pa po natatanggap ang MRO.
Okay. Thank you, Yusa Kris. Salamat din po sa Malacañang Press Corps. Yan lang po na ang nakuha natin mga tanong. Salamat po.
Maraming salamat po, Yusek Rocky, at sa mga members ng Malacañang Press Corps. Dito po, nagtatapos ang ating press briefing ngayong araw. On behalf po of Acting Presidential Spokesperson Martin Andanar, maraming salamat po sa inyo. We'll see you on the other side. God bless everyone. Stay healthy, everyone.